Hello everybody and welcome to another NetHunt CRM tutorial. When it comes to sales and a CRM, we all see this word written in caps, pipeline. So what is the pipeline itself? I'll be quick. A pipeline shows how awesome, or not really, your sales reps are. It's a report showing you the deals your sales managers are working on and expect to close within a time frame you set for them. In NetHunt, there are a few ways to track this flow. The first one is to actually build a funnel the deals are going through. I open my deals folder and group them by stage field. I get myself a beautiful card view. Here I see all of the deals in all the stages they have, but I will hide the won and lost stages to track only the current deals that are gonna close. On the cards, I see the deal amount. I want to also check the manager assigned and how many days this deal has been in this stage. So I click here and add the relevant fields. Now the view shows some good stats, right? I will save it for myself and use it at the meetings. Now, you can create a special sales pipeline report that shows your team's progress on closing deals for a certain time period. Go into the report section and find the pipeline report. Click on a plus sign to create one. Here I fill out the data, give it a name, choose a folder of deals, choose a stage field to trigger. I match the fields for won and lost deals and specify the field for deals value in the manager field. Now, I gotta adjust the time period I want to show the pipeline progress. I actually want to compare this week to a previous one. You can choose any time frame you like from the drop-down or set your custom one. You can also untoggle the periods comparison, but let's leave it to spice up the competition in your team. Thus, the report gives me the list of managers. This number shows me the amount of deals a representative closed this week and last week. And here I get their progress. Here's the money earned in both periods. I wish we could skip this part, but the report also shows the lost deals and their percentage. You can create as many reports as you want with different managers, folders, and time periods. The list will be kept over here. However, the cool thing is to see it on the dashboard. You can add a widget and choose the pipeline report. Be aware that you can choose only one statistic to show in a widget, either won or lost deals or the deal size. I will keep it positive with the won deals so far. Not only you can track the deals closure, but also check the sales activity. In the same place, create a user activity report. You can track their activity in all the folder or select a few. Choose to show all the users or only part of your team, and of course indicate the time periods. Here, I do not want to compare them. I just want to see the actual amount. And now, I can also add it as a widget on a dashboard. I actually want to track how many emails they have sent. And there you go. Two beautiful reports. But that's not enough. Let's make our work more entertaining. I'm gonna set up a goals dashboard for my team. This one can either show how many deals they have to close this week based on the pipeline report, or how many emails or calls and so on they gotta make this week. So I'll make the one for the pipeline, and they all gotta close at least 5 deals each. Wow, look at that! My team is on fire! Bonuses are coming. This will come in handy at our weekly meetings, because the data doesn't lie, right? Plus, it will drive their sales performance. If you found this video useful, hit those like and subscribe buttons. We post informational videos every week, so let us know what you want to hear about next week in the comments below. If you still haven't tried NetHunt, sign up today for free. The link is in the description. Bye for now.